Hello, thank you for watching High Sessions. John Yamasato here. Today's episode features Mo Scanlon. Mo is a newer upcoming artist, and she's been produced by Imuel Garza, who we all love here, and very excited to have her on. Hope you're all doing well, and thank you for liking our page and commenting and all that stuff. It's really fun to read everything, and we just appreciate you for watching the show. Thanks, and have a great day.
Desire to serve you for all time, and I'll give you the glory, glory, glory.
Suzy Kagami from Hawaii Music Live. Thanks for stopping by today.
My pleasure.
Wait, Hawaii Music Live, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. What news do we have coming up in about 4 or 5 months?
4 or 5 months.
Yeah, so this would be, what is it, June? Like September, October.
Kahula Dewey.
Oh,
Kahula. Kuno Marfo Omaru and Academy of Fine Arts.
Where they? Oh, they're gonna be at.
They're gonna do a show together on the mainland.
Oh, yeah, nice.
That'll be cool.
So check out HawaiiMusicLive.com.
Yes.
Okay. Thanks for stopping by. Imuel Garza, can I ask you about your guitar?
Yeah, this is a Taylor,
right.
And it's a 714 C E, which I think means cut away.
Yeah, yeah.
I got it when I was probably 18. My uncle went to the Taylor factory and bought 5 Taylor guitars.
Wow, you gotta.
Didn't know, he thought I would play ukulele, and I was kind of getting into guitar then. And he said, hey, try this one out. And I just strummed like a couple chords, like just G and E, that's all I knew really. And he's like, oh, I didn't know you play guitar. Why don't you have it? So, Uncle Mario.
Wow.
Love you, my favorite uncle.
Yeah, nice. And is this the same one you use with Kimie?
This is the same one that I use for.
It sounds great, and you go just straight in, right?
I put a
straight into a Fishman.
This is a Fishman Loudbox Mini. I use it mostly because I got a new pickup system in here too. It's the LR Bags, the Anthem.
Yeah.
And it's got a nice blend of. I use mostly the mic side.
Yeah, yeah.
So it sounds more natural.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then this amp I found to be the best because. It sounds.
You don't get feedback
natural.
With using the mic side of the.
I can't face it towards. Yeah. Like I can't really put it in the monitor too much. So this one I mostly use just for the verb and like the EQ section. It's nice. And the preamp.
Sounds good, man. And you are a monster on that thing.
And okay. I got it refretted and I got new pegs and stuff. So
cool.
I never really put money into it too much until it started breaking. I'm like, I should probably fix it. I got a lot of kinks, a lot of love through this. Kind of like Barry Flanagan's guitar, almost. There's almost holes all over the place.
Sure.
I broke it like in Japan, it fell, and this whole thing fell off. So it's been through a lot.
But still sounds good.
Yeah. And sounds not too bad.
Very good. Well, thanks for coming by again.
Yeah. Can't wait.
You never forsake me, and to you I'll give you the glory, glory, because you came into my life.
Okay, I'm here with Mo Scanlon for our 3-minute interview, starting now. Okay, Mo, so take us back to the beginning. How did you get involved with music and singing?
Well, I first moved here back in the early 90s. I did a couple of gigs in Waikiki, and I took a break, 10 years, and then I wrote my own stuff and contacted Imuel.
Oh, so it was an out of the blue call to Imuel?
Well, we served together on the worship team at church. So.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because of all people to get hooked up with, he's probably as good as you can get.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And the album.
He's the best.
Yeah. Yeah, he's super. And the album comes out today, or is it printed today? Or I heard something about today being something significant.
Well, today is my CD release party.
Oh.
Yeah.
Where's it going to be?
It's going to be at 53 by the Sea.
Oh, that's a nice spot.
Yeah, it's pretty sweet.
Okay, and are you excited about it?
I am. My whole family's flying down from LA My daughter is going to be singing with me. Of course, she'll have the best band.
Which, you're originally from California?
Originally, yes. Born and raised in Los Angeles.
Okay, and when you were growing up, did you do a lot of singing then too, or what?
My parents are musicians, and so they raised us on the road.
Oh, really?
And, but I didn't do it professionally until I was 18 when I moved here.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Well, so you've been here since you're 18.
Mm-hmm. I was in the Love Note show.
I think we just gave away your age. People do the
math. I'm proud of my age.
Well, it's very cool. And who are kind of your influences? Because it's very contemporary what you've been doing.
Well, my parents, I was fortunate enough to be raised by musicians, so I was influenced heavily by soul. They listened to a lot of Earth, Wind & Fire. A lot of the big bands like Chicago, Doobie Brothers, but I would say my influences are India Ari, definitely.
Nice.
She's a big influence.
And do you do any plan on like touring or gigging, or what is the deal with the music?
I plan to do some gigs in Los Angeles. So.
Oh, so LA.
The album.
Uh-huh. Get ready, because Mo's coming your way.
Yay.
When do you think that'll happen? Toward the end of the year?
Probably the end of summer.
Oh, so by the time this airs. Okay, so watch out, everybody, and thank you very much for coming in. We had a pleasure having you on the show.
Thank you so much.
And hopefully we'll see you again soon.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.